We have to now study projection with link. What is projection? First of all, let us understand what is projection, how it is done in traditional SQL. Then we will see how to do it with link. So here we go. Let us understand how projection is done in SQL. Suppose we write a query like this. Select star from TBLX. And TBLX has, let us suppose, C1, C2, C3, C4. It has 4 columns. When we write select star, it selects all the columns. So basically it will select all C1, C2, C3, C4. But if I want to select only C1 and C2, then that is called projection. If I write select C1, C2 from TBLX, then this is called projection. By default, the table that comes after projection has 2 columns having same name as C1 and C2. The columns will be same C1 and C2. But if we want to give them different names, then how do we do in traditional? We write select C1 as col1, comma C2 as col2 from TBLX. So in this case you are giving aliases to the 2 columns. Oracle has a different way of giving the alias, SQL has different way, but at the end of the day both are aliases now. The point is that aliases can be given. If we don't write this, then C1 is alias and C2 is alias. If we write this, then it is specifically col1 is the alias and col2 is the alias. So projection is taking out certain columns from a table instead of all the columns and optionally giving them certain aliases. This can be done with link also, and let us see. This is our project that we have been doing till last time. This is the index action that will be called, and that returns get data. And get data function returns a grouping we were studying. So basically this is our order data, is our database, and we can now remove this part to write today's code. Okay. How do we take all columns? We can write where query is equal to ls. So this gives me all the columns basically. But if I want to take only amount and invoice too, I will use dot select. The collection is of type C order data. And here I'll write x select dot x. So C order data is the type of the collection. This accepts 2 arguments. If you see here, one is the source, the other is the result. The T source is the type of source, that is the type of the collection, and T result is the type of the result. In this case, T source is C order data. And the result is a new object. If we define a separate class for that, then that class will be set here. But generally we do not need to set a new class. We can simply use the dynamic keyword of C#. This dynamic keyword will actually say the type is determined dynamically by the compiler.